Oh man, come on. Yeah, come on. Defense, defense, defense. Another disappointment year. Oh, freaking Jeff. Yo, let's do it. Let's do it, Mello. Hit it. Swish. Make it happen, baby. Yes. Oh, my goodness. Defense. 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 Come on, Knicks. Let's do it. Let's do it. Oh. Another disappointment season. Next year, maybe next year, man, we're gonna make it happen. New York! Rangers! Let's go, Rangers! Come on, man, don't forget the dream. I'm wearing a lucky shirt, 2014. Let's make it happen. Come on! Come on! Oh my God, I can't believe you guys lost to the Flyers in the playoffs. Oh my God. Well, there's always next year. Hey guys, what's going on? My name is Darryl Mcclish, retired lieutenant. Out here to give you guys the top 100 mistakes that people make in their route to the bad life. Hope you guys enjoyed my little skit I put out there. I am passionate about my teams, right? I am an East Coast type of guy and I love my sports team. But here today, I'm gonna talk to you guys about that extreme level, about people who have a greater passion toward the sport team, right? And this is mistake number 8 that I've seen people making their route to the bad line. And that is having a greater passion toward your sports team than your job, or your goals, or your vision, or your family. You know, as you write that down, does it actually sound crazy? Does it sound ridiculous? Because I know to me, once I seen it on paper, it rocked me to the core. I said, how can I have a greater passion toward my sports team than my children? Right? But some people do. Some people go through their entire life totally obsessed, okay, with the success of their sports team and totally forgetting about the success of their entire life. Who does that? Who does that? 90% of the people out there having a bad life. That's right, 90% of the people out there having a bad life are still passionate about a sports team. Still won't miss a Sunday game. Still won't miss a playoff. Still won't miss a World Series game. You know, Stanley Cup playoff, they won't miss it, but they will allow days, weeks, months, okay, without spending time with their children. Days, weeks, months without contributing to their job. You know, to just show up to work every day, plop themselves down to the chair and do the bare minimum. Come on, guys. Are you serious? Life is meant to be lived. The sole purpose of you being put here, okay, it's to do the best that you can do with whatever you have. You know, my mentor squared me away on this when they told me, listen, you need to be excited about your goals, all right? Instead of being a season ticket holder, you need to be going to conventions, right? You need to be hooking up with mentors. You need to be pursuing that which gets you and your family ahead in life. And they have a passion about it. You know, people love to escape life, right? And know what I found out over time as I watched so many people head down that path to the bad life? And I'm talking about thousands and thousands of people. head down that path, this path to the bad life. I've noticed that people love to escape reality, right? And they escape reality for no reason whatsoever. Not that they can't achieve great things, because obviously if they have a great passion toward their sports team, they can have a great passion toward their goals. They can have a great passion toward their family. They can have a great passion toward their vision. So the energy is there, okay? Their focus is off. All right, they're following the wrong people. All right, why are you sitting there in your life doing bad, but still following the people, okay, who have a passion that has nothing to do with your life? Whether my team wins or loses has absolutely nothing to do with my life. So why was I so caught up in it? You know, the display of greatness, the display of athletic abilities, you know, the great things that they've done. You know, I tell you what, guys, if you dedicate your entire life to your goal, if you dedicate your entire life to your job, if you dedicate your entire life to your family, I guarantee you, you'll be a pro in all those areas. You'll be the greatest dad ever. You'll be super dad. You'll be the freaking LeBron James Michael Jordan dad if you truly dedicated your life to your children. Right? If you truly dedicated your life to your job, your employer, that mission, you would be the Wayne Gretzky, okay, of your job. You would do it. Everyone will be coming to you for anything that they need when it comes to your job. But we don't do that as people. I didn't do that as people. I made that mistake, right? My passion was misdirected towards someone else's goal, towards someone else's vision. I'm asking you guys right here, right now, what my mentors told me, to refocus your goals. To write them down. You know, these days I write everything down because I can't leave nothing to memory. Because I believe that memory is flawed, right? And if you write things down and you read them and you come back to them, you can refocus immediately. But if you leave it up to memory, a lot of times you distort your reality. So as we go through these top 100 mistakes that people make in their route to the bad life, you need to have a passion toward things that are important and affect your life. Okay, and I'm not telling you not to enjoy your sports team. I love my sports team, right? But my passion, I love my life more. I love my family more, right? I love my job more. Yeah, if you don't love your job, then leave it. Leave your job, man. Find something that truly you can be passionate about and you can dedicate some hard work and some dedication to so you can move up and make a difference. Okay? Just don't be in a job just to be in a job. Don't, like I talked about, you know, in that last mistake that people made, don't be at a job just to pay the bills. Don't do it to yourself. Right? Have a passion about what you're doing. Once you have a passion, you will annihilate barriers in your job, in your life. And income will follow. You will have that good life when it comes to your career. Because you will be excited about what you do every day. You'll be excited about the people that you interact within your realm of influence. So that is what is important. Having a great passion towards your job, having a great passion towards your goals, having a great passion towards your vision, and most important, having a great passion towards your family, right? Being excited about your family and helping them, raising them to the level that you're trying to achieve. Okay, don't be selfish about life. Raise your family too, okay? So hopefully you guys, I've given you something of value, and if I have, man, click on my link, all right, and subscribe to Darryl Mcclish TV. And if you have somebody in your life who doesn't have a passion, doesn't have a focus, or is so caught up in a sports team, I mean, I had it in my life, people that were emotional, they cry every time their sports team lost, and cheer and scream every time their sports team won. It would make their day, ruin their day. I've had them in my life. And if you have one in your life as well, click on my link, subscribe to Darryl Mcclish TV, and share it with them. Share my link with them, because as I said before, you cannot be a prophet in your own city, right? So just redirect them to my website, my Darryl Mcclish TV. Share this link, and hopefully I can affect them and get your message across to them, right? Because that's what it's about, right? Making everybody around you's lives better. So check me out on Instagram. I'm always putting out great inspirational stuff from several different entrepreneurs, not just myself. And Facebook, check me out at Darryl Mcclish TV on Facebook. And also, if you guys like to read my blog at rivetedlifestyle.com. And I will talk to you guys tomorrow with the next tip. Talk to you later. Hey, listen, thanks for showing up. Bye-bye.